The Jazz had 9 days off during the All-Star break, so we expected a team that would be fresh and full of energy coming out of the All-Star break. Instead, we got quite the opposite as the Jazz got whipped by the San Antonio Spurs, the 10th best team in the Western Conference. Kind of a shocking result tonight. Did not expect to see this. Rudy Gobert, he looked pretty good in the first quarter of this game. Fresh off a 21-point, 11-rebound performance in his first NBA All-Star game. He's a force in the paint, as he always, with some impressive dunks. He had 18 points and 14 rebounds. Donovan Mitchell seems to have his legs after the break. His signature lift off in the paint for the powerful finish, but he struggled tonight. Just 12 points and 5 of 14 shooting. The Jazz lacked intensity tonight in their first game back from the break. The Spurs went on a 17-0 run in the second quarter to take advantage and take control. LaMarcus Aldridge and DeMar DeRozan bullied the Jazz to claim a 65-46 halftime lead. We go to the second half. The Jazz were down by as much as 25 points. Someone needed to step up and provide a spark. It turned out to be Emmanuel Mudiay. He led a 16-3 Jazz run by pushing the basketball and putting pressure on the Spurs defense. A 25-point lead cut to 12, but the damage had been done. The Spurs shoot 50% from three, and they mid-ranged the Jazz to death. A very poor effort against the 10th best team in the West. Here's Quinn Snyder's blunt assessment.
We got what we earned tonight. And now it's give San Antonio credit. They came out and played with force. They were not just the more aggressive team, but more aggressive team by the long way.
The Jazz have to move on quickly. James Harden, Russell Westbrook, and the Rockets here tomorrow night. Back to you guys.